Welcome back to another video, everybody. Max here with Catrol Hunting, and today I have another awesome junk silver purchase that I want to share with you guys. Lately I've been pretty lucky on that front. It's not usually normal for me to buy that often, but if I get deals like this, I will not pass on them, and I'm super happy to have this. So the story behind this is, again, I went to one of my junk silver dealers who is not a coin shop or anything like this. It is just a person that buys and sells all kinds of silver products and sells them to a refinery or something like this. And so the good thing about that is that he doesn't particularly care about coins that much. He basically just cares about getting more value than he paid for it and is very, very reasonable with his prices. So he had a box of coins that was all mixed percentages. There were some 50%ers in there, there was some 72%ers in there, all kinds of stuff. And he basically told me, you can have anything in this bin for 86 cent Canadian per gram, which is a pretty good deal. I mean, this is a pretty normal rate that you would get for mixed junk silver coins, but the fact that he let me pick it makes it much better for me, obviously, because you can actually achieve getting silver slightly under spot like this. In the end, I paid $205 Canadian dollars for this, and the silver value of this is around $230. So this is roughly 10% under spot, which is amazing for the quality of the coins that I got here. So I'm super, super thrilled to show you guys. Let's start with the American coinage. So we have four Barber half dollars. We have a 1908, an 1894-0, I believe, is this. Yes, it's an 1894-0. Then we have a 1913, and the best thing, a 1915, which is a very, very, very low mintage year and a very, very hard coin to find. So to have this in a junk silver bin is very, very, very tough and very, very awesome. I'm super, super happy with this. The condition is not the best, it's just slick, but I checked it and it is legit. So with those kind of coins, I'm always a little bit wary if they are fake. I'm super happy to pick this up. Not that I particularly want numismatic coins like this, but if I have them and can trade them in the future or something like this, it is amazing. We had one Barber quarter from 1916, a common date, and then we had four Standing Liberty quarters. So I took all of the US coinage that was in that bin. There was no Mercury dimes or anything like that, so I took those coins, and these are all very, very rough, in rough shape. They look kind of burnt or something from one side, but they're still SLQs and they are all a visible date. I think we have a 1919, a 1920, this one is hard to see on camera, and then I think we have a 30 and a 29 if I remember right. Yeah, still awesome, 90% constitutional junk silver. Very, very happy about this. Over here we have five German Mark from the 60s and early 70s. That's the common German silver coin. Very, very common coin, but these three were in very nice condition, so I kept them. They're all 62.5% silver, so not the highest silver amount and not so amazing for that price, but I still wanted them, so I took them. Over here we have 3 1-rupee from British India in 1912, 1919 and 1917, and these ones are amazing to get for this price. They're sterling silver, they are beautiful coins, they have a very, very, very pretty design. I like it a lot, with George V on the back. Super, super happy to pick those up. Next to this we have 1 florin from Australia, 1938. Also a pretty nice coin, sterling silver. Very, very happy to have that one. Over here we have a 2 shilling, 1894, and there is another 2 shilling or 1 florin from Australia, 1931. Also sterling silver coins, pretty awesome. Over here we have a Bolivar, or no, this is actually a 2 bolivar from Venezuela, 1929. Very, very slick, but still nice variety with Bolivar Libertador. Tato on there, very, very nice. Next to it is a 2 franc, 1895, older French coin. This one got cleaned for sure, but still a very, very pretty coin. And this one is an 80% silver coin. And over here we have another Florian, but this one is Victorian, so it's I can't see the date completely on this one, but it's definitely from the 1800s, and it is very slick and has the young bust of Victoria on it, so it's probably somewhere in the 1850s. But it's a very, very nice sterling silver coin, old British silver. Very happy to have this. Let's go up here to the smaller stuff. Nothing like super old this time, but everything's still good. This is a 1 shilling UK sterling silver, also the date not clearly visible. You can see a 9 over there and maybe even a 4, so this is tough to say what this is, but still a very, very nice coin. This one here is another Bolivar from Venezuela, but this one is a 1 Bolivar. Next to it, I think this is probably one of the older coins here. This is a Belgium coin, 1 crown, 1 franc, sorry. And this one is Leopold II, so it must be somewhere in the late 1800s, but again, the date is not really visible, so it's really hard to tell. Still a nice pickup for that price. And we have next to it 2 1 franc from France. This one is a bit newer, it's a 1908, and I think this one had a date on there. Let me just see quickly here. This one is an 1872, so that's a nice date too. Very, very nice design. I love this old franc design. Very, very beautiful. And then we have a few other small pieces. We have a couple of sixpence from Australia. We have a couple of sixpence from the UK. 50 centavos from centimes, sorry, from France. Here, this coin is actually pretty good. It's a low mintage coin and a very, very nice condition. So I really think that this might be one of the best here, this 1916 Australian sixpence. Very, very nice. And then last but not least, we have this very, very tiny, beautiful 2 annas, also from British India. Those coins have a beautiful design. I'm a huge fan. Overall, this was an awesome pickup. I would not pass up anything like this. And this is also one thing we talked about our stream last time. Picking up silver coins doesn't always mean you need to go to a coin shop. There's a lot of scrap metal dealers out there that are willing to sell you coins for less than the coin shops would. And it is a great spot to find those kind of coins because they usually do not care that much about the numismatic value, and they will be happy to sell you coins as long as you give them a little bit of a spot. And very often they are also reasonable, or they do not know the percentages very, very well of the coins. So when they buy it, they often pay 50% silver price for 80% and more coins. And so they're very flexible on their prices. At least that's what I experienced in the past. And as you guys know, I love this kind of stuff, and getting barber halves for effectively $10 Canadian each is a very, very, very good deal. Nothing wrong with that, and I would do that any day of the week. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you enjoy videos like this, leave a comment. Let me know if you think this was a great purchase and if you would have done the same. I will continue uploading videos like this. Maybe I show you guys some eBay purchases at some point as well. But for now, I am out of here, and I wish you guys an awesome day. And if you guys haven't subscribed yet, please consider doing so. There's going to be more awesome content on this channel. Thank you guys so much, and have a good one.